This is a chain drive differential that was on a Jedi single seater. At the Forrestburn Hillclimb, and the guy sheared the output shaft. It's a 10 spline output shaft for an LSD. However, it's been machined down on this diameter here to fit inside this long bearing that's been fitted. So I've taken one out of my Quaife LSD. As you can see, it's a much larger diameter. Been machined down in a couple of grooves to let oil through. Sorry, machined down the outer diameter, and then it's got a couple of oil grooves machined into it as well, just to let oil flow out to the outer bronze bearing. So it'll be quite an easy fix, just machine this so it fits inside that recess and grind a couple of slots in it, and that should replicate what you had. Fairly easy fix. Right, I'll put that in the lathe and machine it down. Quite hard material. Machine this down to 34.5mm diameter. A wee fraction of sharp, stringy stuff. That should be a spot on size, that diameter now. Remove this swarf out, cut myself, and then put a couple of chamfers on the edges. I'll be ready to grind three grooves into it. Right, that slots in there fine. So it's nice and flush. Well, I could do with a battery on that. Not a Quaife. I've got a scraper somewhere. My Astro Tools scraper, carbide scraper. Got that for Christmas. Not used it yet. Carbide scraper. Good for taking off old sealant. these have been tapped to A-mate, I suspect. Certainly the ones I took out there were A-mate. Have I got any A-mates? There are longer screws back with the Jedi, but they're holding on the rear airfoil, the rear wings held on off the diff. See how well that slots on. Pushes right down. These will clamp up eventually with big bolts through there. Let's just check that dimension. I measured the dimension from this face to the face of the sprocket at 32 millimetres approximately. 32 millimetres. So that's where it goes. Let's see if we've got any squirty stuff that's not set solid. Oh yes, we're getting some gloop. Lovely stuff. And a wee bit round the bearing. Let's give a seal to the bearing. Together. Should just slot on. Probably want to stick some long bolts through that to clamp it up while it sits. Tight. Anyway, you get right. I've put cross bolts in to clamp it up onto the bearing and covered it with polyurethane sealant. Try and get off my hands and try and get off the excess. Just lightly clamped up the outer cover. Takes off the polyurethane adhesive reasonably easily. Takes the worst of it off anyway. There. All fixed. There's a pattern of the brake, the piece that came off, and you could see a twist in the splines at the point where it broke off. Some fracture, eh?